for Michael Mass.
If I known I was going to have to follow her, I just would have worked harder. I met her when we first started, and I had the hots for her, but she was married. He's there, you know. And she's smart, you know. I want to mention this one thing.
Ms. O'Leary, tear down this wall.
It doesn't do anything. I'm Michael Mast, and I'm here because my girlfriend thought it would be good for me to be involved in a stand-up comedy workshop, because she thought I had self-esteem issues, and which is like encouraging a man with a chronic muscle tremor, which I have, to go into watchmaking or bond repair. But actually, stand-up is bomb repair. But she said I could either do the stand-up comedy workshop, or I could start making love to her more often. And I thought, I don't want to disappoint her yet again. and if I'm going to suffer performance anxiety anyway, I might as well do it in comfortable clothes, with a spotlight, but no lube required. I was born in upstate New York, in the Finger Lakes region. You don't know where it is. It's the Finger Lakes are just not near anything. They're not near themselves. They're they were formed, by the way, by retreating glaciers, a few years before I was born. And apparently glaciers get homesick because they came back every damn year. At the age of 12, I had learned everything I ever wanted to know about winter. Thanksgiving gatherings with the family. Frostbite. I got over the frostbite. Now, this is the 1950s, which was a strange, long ago time. We had a president, Dwight Eisenhower. He looked like a baby, but he acted like a grown-up. And we had these wonderful, neat, well-functioning families who always did the right thing, like Father Knows Best, on television. I, on the other hand, had a stepfather. We moved a lot, and I was small. But I ended up back in the town in which I was born. You don't know it, you never heard of it, it's not near anything, forget about it, it's in the Finger Lakes. And I'm in a clothing store, I'm selling clothes, in a family home clothing store. And I hook up with this young woman who also works at the store, named Sarah. Sarah is the boss's daughter. What could go wrong? The courtship was rocky, but the marriage, not so good. And I had to move. Uh, But that's how horny I was in 1969. My younger brother joined the Navy because Vietnam was going on and he didn't want to, you know. And he ended up in his training in the Great Lakes, not the Finger Lakes, the Great Lakes, you know, in January. He survived that, and a year later he wrote me a letter. A letter was a piece of paper. With words on it, you know, and you folded it up, and put it into a pouch, like an envelope, and you put money on it, and you wrote the name of the person you wanted to read this, and their location, and if you gave it to the right person, it would frickin' get to them. It was incredible. It was amazing. Anyway, so I get this letter and he invites me to come down to where he's stationed. Now I had enough money to pay the rent on my basement apartment or leave town. So 2 days, 2 nights on a Greyhound bus. I do not recommend it. I arrive in Pensacola, Florida. No money, no friends, no social life, nothing. I get a job in a shady clothing store run by a gay guy named Bert. Now, I have no friends, money, I have nothing, no social life, except for my gay boss. Now, on the top floor of the San Carlos Hotel, which is where I live, by the way, every Saturday night, they would hold these amazing drag shows. Unbelievable. It was all news to me because I'm from the Finger Lakes. But I want you to imagine, you know, there you are. It's in a darkened ballroom. It's 1:20 in the morning. You're 22. You're lonely. You know, you're lonely. And there in the spotlight, it's just unbelievable, 6 foot tall, beauty, in a silver gown with rose overtones, actually. Huge hair, jewelry, glam makeup, you know. And she starts moving like a dancer. And then she goes into Aretha Franklin's rendition of Carole King's "You Make Me Feel." Wait for it. "You Make Me Feel." You make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. And I'm thinking, I do her.
Thank you. He made me feel like a natural.